Okay, so now that we've finished all the pieces, next you just need to stitch them all on. So I've just pinned them so you can see roughly where they'll go. Okay. Okay, so when I'm stitching on body pieces, I like to start with the legs. Okay. So they're going to sit under the body. About there. You can always pin these on. Okay, and I've made sure the legs aren't fully stuffed. So I just go through one stitch and out the other side. And then I want to go through this top stitch. So I'm joining both sides together as I stitch it onto the body. Okay, so I go through the top stitch and the bottom stitch, and then I go through the body. So through both of them there. Okay, and just make sure you've still got it lined up where you want it. Okay, so once you have this one stitched on, then just stitch this one on next. Okay, so once you've finished stitching this one on, just line up the next one and stitch that on. And then when you're happy with them, you can okay, so once they're both stitched on, you can decide if you want to have them loose like this or always sitting. So you can just stitch this piece in there and then it will always be in the sitting position. And then once you're happy with where both of them are stitched together, just tie the two yarn tails together and hide them in the body. Okay, to stitch on the arms, these aren't fully stuffed again. It's about to there. They go under the neck and on an angle. And the weight of these should help it sit up. So you can test it by stitching them on. Okay, and I just stitch it on the same way I did with the leg. So you go through both sides of the arm and then through the body. Okay, so just behind one stitch. Then obviously after you finish this one, you want to do the next arm. Make sure they're straight and where you want them. And then use the two yarn tails to knot them together and hide it in the body. Okay, so I stitched on both my arms. Okay, they're not perfect, but that's all right. And I didn't want them flopping around so much, so I've stitched just through the arm and then back through the body twice on each arm. And then I put the yarn tails at their back. You just want to pull them tight and knot them so they stay in place. Okay, and then just weave these tails in. To stitch on the ears, I'm just going to fold it at the bottom. Okay, so it kind of looks like a flower petal. And I'm going to stitch it just back from these eyelashes, so about there. Okay, and I'm just going to go through the head and through the ear until I feel that it's secure and it's not going to come off. Okay. And then, of course, I'm going to do the other one in the same spot on the other side of the head. Just back here, and I'll try and get it on the same row. And then I'll bring the yarn tails out to the back, knot them, and hide them in the head. Okay, here's how the ears look. So the last thing to do is to stitch on the tail and then make some nostrils and a mouth. Okay, so just stitch it on any way you like. And I haven't added any stuffing to this tail. Okay, to make the nose, just get a long bit of yarn and your needle. Go through the center. And then you want to come out where you want the end of your first nostril. So you want it to line up kind of with the end of the ear. And then you want to go over about 3 stitches. Okay. And you just want to keep going over that until it's big enough. If you want them a bit bigger, you can go over 4 stitches instead of 3. And once this one is big enough, then you just go and make the other one. And if your yarn is long enough, you can also do the mouth with the same bit of yarn. Okay, once you're finished with your nostrils, you can go ahead and make your mouth any way you like. Okay, so once you're happy with how it looks, you just knot the two ends together and hide it in the head. Okay, thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.